Hey, what's up? This is Jamal Abbott here to show you how to set up faxing on your 8x8 phone system. Now, this is the easiest fax setup that I've ever seen in my lifetime supporting these phone systems. So in today's lesson, we're going to learn how to set up a fax line for your user profile. We'll also go through some steps with sending a fax as well as receiving a fax. We do this first by going to users, and we're going to choose the user account that we want to set up for a fax. We'll select me. From here, we can scroll down until we see fax settings, but I'm going to go here to this left-hand side here where it says fax notification settings, and that's where you're going to go to actually set up the fax number. From this section here, we have a couple of variables here. One, we need to set up a fax number. We have notification email and this, and another part about how we want to receive faxes. First part here, we're going to select the phone number, and I have this number available from the system. Now, if you want to know how to actually get numbers into your phone system, check out this video that I did on claiming phone numbers. It explains the process and it's pretty simple. We have our fax number set up and we have a notification email address. Now, depending upon your organization or how you're set up for your business, you may want to set this for a personal email address, or it might be okay to set this up for a group email. So it all depends on how you want to handle that. And then notify me by email when I receive or send a fax. You can either disable the notification or have an attachment only. Now, just stick with me here real quick. I'm going to talk a little bit more about why you may not want to have attachments sent to your email. And that's because of the fact that some of these faxes that you're getting, they may be sensitive in nature, especially if you're like a medical facility or have anything to do with sensitive documents. So you may not want to actually receive this attachment and then get the fax actually through your 8x8 phone system. Now, I'm going to let you know there's a nice link that's in the description that talks about 8x8 security and its compliance. It's definitely worth the read and checking out. And this should give you a little bit more information why you'll want to receive your fax through the 8x8 phone system instead of it having sent to you via email. So we have everything in place. I'm going to leave the notifications off and going to click save. And then from here, we're pretty much set up and we're going to see how we're actually going to send a fax. Now that we have the settings saved, I'm going to pull up my soft phone client, and this is the 8x8 virtual office app. Let me go ahead and just log out here real quick, and we're going to log back in just to let these settings take effect. We're here in the virtual office app. And if you look towards the left, you see a little paper, and that's our fax area. Once I click that, you see that there's no faxes present that I've either sent or received, but I do have an icon down here at the very bottom to send a fax. So at this point right now, we're going to go ahead and send a fax. And when you're brought to this screen, it's going to ask you the number that you want to send to, where the fax is coming from, if you want to attach a cover letter, the subject, and then any other additional attachments. So this is what I really enjoy about faxing, and it's kind of funny just thinking about this. I'm saying that I enjoy faxing here in 2020 and beyond if you're looking at this. But the one thing that this pandemic and the stay-at-home orders have taught me is that faxing has actually become a lot more important, especially if you're needing to send sensitive documents that you may not want to send via email, or maybe you don't want to have attached directly to the internet. So just all depends upon your requirements, but just know that faxing is something you may want to pay attention to here going forward. Like email, we want to specify the number that we want to send to, and the number that I'm going to send to is my fax number. And if I don't specify a cover letter here, it's going to default to whatever is populated for my phone system. But just for this example, I'm actually going to bring up an attachment that we're going to drag into this screen. I have the fax that I want to send, so I'm going to take this document and just drag that here, and we see now that our fax is attached to this new fax. So we have everything in place. I'm not going to put a subject in here because as soon as I do that, it's going to put a cover letter here by default. If you take that off and leave it blank, you can leave your own custom fax cover letter document here. Now it's just a matter of clicking this arrow to send off the fax, and we wait for this fax to process. So at this point, we're going to speed this up. You're not going to want to sit here and watch the fax process in this video, so I will catch you on the other side. Our fax has been sent, and we get confirmation of what the fax was that we sent to the end recipient. And then we also have this section here which shows all sent and received faxes. So that's how to send a fax. Now we're going to take a look at what it takes to actually receive a fax. With receiving faxes, it's pretty simple, but if you're not familiar with this process, you're going to give the fax number to the individual that needs to send you something, and they're going to load up the documents on their fax machine or from their fax server and then send that off to you. So I've given my fax number to the end recipient, which is myself in this example, and I'm going to send a fax to my number that we established in our 8x8 phone system. So we're going to see what that looks like to receive a fax on this end of the video. Now with receiving faxes, you'll get notified of an incoming fax by hearing an audible ding, as well as having this icon here at the far left side letting you know that you have a new fax. So depending upon the number of faxes you have, this number will change in regards to the number of different faxes that you've received. So to retrieve the fax, I'm going to go ahead and click this fax section. And then now I see I have the fax that I sent earlier today, and now with a fax from this new number showing that it's present here for me. So once I click this, I see the copy of the fax, I see the details here, and this is the fax document itself. So we learned in this video about how to set up faxes for your 8x8 phone system. We also learned how to send as well as receive faxes and covered the importance of security when it comes to faxing through your 8x8 phone system. If you have any questions, let me know. Comments, feedback, always appreciate that as well too. Let me know, drop them in the comments. This is Jamal Abbott. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.